Good morning, children. Welcome to your EVS class. We are going to start with chapter number 5, Anita and the Honeybees. So here's a lesson about a little girl, Anita, and how she became a honeybee seller. Okay. She belongs to the village name as Bochaha, which is in Muzaffarpur district in Bihar. So look at the map carefully, and where does Bihar fall in? India. It is at the eastern side. Can you see in the map? And here the story begins. She says that besides studying, I also teach young children and I also keep bees. She does two types of work. She is a teacher to young children and she also keeps beehives, okay, where she can collect honey. And for so many years she spent time grazing her goats, where her parents did not allow her to go to school. But then she wanted to go to school. So one day she went and sat in the classroom. And then she liked it very much. She was very happy. When she came home, she talked to her parents that I want to go to school. But then they clearly said no. So her teachers came to know. And then they talked to her parents that no, it is her right. It is a right to education. So that is our constitutional right. Living in India, being the citizen of India, it is our right to get free education till standard 8. The government is going to provide in the government school with free fees along with midday meal. The children are going to get free food, right? So similarly, the teachers came and explained to her parents. So they agreed to send their child, that is Anita, to the school. Now there is an activity list out. How many money do you spend in 1 year for the various school related activities? Just jot down the amount of money that you spend for your school. Okay. Now coming to the next page, page number 34, there is a question. How much money did you spend on your books this year? So just calculate and write the amount. Draw a picture of the school uniform of your choice in your notebook. You're not going to draw it in the notebook. You can draw it in an A4 size paper and then stick that in your notebook. Then now study continues, where she continues. She passes out standard 5th. But then she realizes that now the expenses for her studies are going to increase. So she started taking tuitions of younger children to her. Okay. Then she started earning money to help herself. Right. Then she also then started talking to parents of the children. Basically the girls. Where the parents would not want her, that girl child to go to school and get education. So she started advocating that. And then her mother used to do all her household work so that she can study further. So this way her family also started cooperating her in her studies. Now the next session is going to begin, that is the beekeeper, how she became a beekeeper. Okay, so here she says that after learning that how lucrative it is, how she can earn money out of it, she started taking training in that area. Basically, people do this job of beekeeping. Okay, so the government also provides training over there. So she joined that training, and basically the honeybee lays eggs from the month of October till December. So that is the best time to start beekeeping. So she decided that I'm going to do that. So there are 2-3 questions, like how have you seen any insect near the flower? Find out the name and write it. Then why do they come near the flower? Just find it out. Then the next is draw and color their picture in your notebook. No, you will not do in your notebook. You can do it in A4 size paper and then stick it. And the next is when honeybees fly, there is a kind of sound. Can you try to copy that? Have you heard that sound? Something like that. Yes. Yes. I'm able to copy. You think about yourself whether you are able to copy or not. Now Anita had completed the course of becoming a beekeeper. But then to start the business, she needs money. So now she had to work very hard. And what was she previously doing? Yes, she was taking tuition. She was teaching young children. Okay, so then she collected 5,000 rupees because she need to buy the box, whatever material she needs to do the business of beekeeping. So one box of beekeeping will cost her 2000. So she bought two boxes which cost her 4000, and then 1000 is still left. Out of that, she bought the other necessary material like the sugar to make the syrup for honeybees and medicine to clean the beehives. Okay, because she needs to keep this beehive clean, right? Then coming to the next page, Anita and the honeybee. That was in September. By December, I had so many bees. Still, I had to buy two more boxes. Now, she was already having two boxes, and by December, she had many bees, okay, in the box. I was still learning about the beekeeping. See, now she had done the course, but practically doing something is different. Now she was still learning. Every day she will face some new challenge, right? Many times the bees would sting me and my hands and my face would get swollen. See, the bees are not her friends. They're going to sting her. They're going to bite her. And then the portion that they bite is going to get swollen. So that pain also she had to bear. But she was not able to tell it to anybody. Why? Because this job she had selected on her own. She had decided on her own that I'm going to do this. So when you suffer out of this, you cannot tell, you cannot complain about it, right? And then find out. What is there to find out? What do people do when the bee has stung? If you get a bee bite, if the bee bites you, if the bee stings you, what is the medicine that you do? That you will find out the answer, okay? I will tell you the right answer afterwards. Then is draw a picture of the honeybee in your notebook. No, not in your notebook, in A4 size paper, and then you can stick it in your notebook. On the lychee tree, flowers have bloomed in February. I put all my boxes near the lychee tree. I collected 12 kg of honey from each box. I sold the honey in the market, and this was the first earning from the bees. And now I have 20 boxes. So she started with 2 boxes. And then gradually, she developed her business. She started selling honey, and then gradually she now has 20 boxes. Can you imagine? Yes. What is the rate of her progress? Amazing. Yes. What will be the total cost of Anita's 20 boxes? So now some maths. For one box, the charges are 2000 rupees. So what will be the cost of 20 boxes, right? Then every day I go to the college on cycle. My college is 5 kilometers away in the town. And now you also know a lot about Anita. Yes, we know so much about Anita. Like, she is herself an entrepreneur. She's doing her own business, and she also is interested in studies. She goes to college by cycle. Now Anita is a very active girl. She goes in the village and talks to people about educating girls and about also this honeybee business. Now everybody knows her, and she never forgets to attend the meeting. And there are some people who would laugh at her. Yes, there are people. No, whenever you do something, some are going to laugh at you. But then she doesn't count all that. Then Anita wants to become a wholesaler of that so that she can help the villagers. She is a producer. She is a retailer. She goes and sells it to the, to the main market. But now she wants to become a wholesaler where everybody will produce and give it to her, and then she will sell it in the market. Okay. So where she is going to be a helping source to others. So she is encouraging everybody. Okay. So now find out, Anita and other people of the village get rupees 30 for 1 kilogram of honey. How much does the kilogram of honey cost in your city? Just find out the cost of honey in your city. Okay. Is honey used in your house, and what it is used for? Do you people use honey at your house, and what is the purpose? How do you use it? Right. Every beehive has one queen bee that lays eggs. Most of the bees in the hive are the worker bees. These bees work whole day. That we watched in the previous video. And then here they are talking about They fly around the flowers, they collect the nectar from the flower to make money, and when any bee finds flowers with nectar, it does a special kind of dance by which others come to know that here the nectar is there, and the worker bees are also very important for the hive. Without them, there would be neither hive nor any other nectar collection. All the bees in the hive would go hungry. So everybody in the team is working hard and playing their own roles. Which are the other insects that live together in group, like honeybee? So find out the insects that live together. Like, we know that ants live together. Have you seen ants? Every time they will go in a group, in a line. I find them so much disciplined. We don't want need to tell them that walk in a line. Everybody walks in a line, right? Ants live and work together in the honeybee. The queen ant, yes, they are talking about the ant. The queen ant lays eggs, and the soldier ant looks after and guards the ant hill. Worker ants are always busy looking for food and bringing it to the ant hill. And even the termites and the wasp also live like this. Have you seen where the ants live and by which food items ants are attracted? Yes, sugar is their favorite food, I think. Every time when some sugar will fall on the ground, all the ants will come together, right? And look at the line of the ants. What is its color? Okay. So then coming to the next is, have you been bitten by an ant? Oh yeah, I have been bitten. You talk about yourself and write the answer. What was the ant like, black or red? I don't think black ever bites. Only the red one bites. Big or small? Okay, then you write the answer. While eating peanuts, you probably throw away the shells. Why don't you try to make some insects by using the shells? Do not forget to color them. Just try this, an activity. Okay, so we are done with the lesson. Thank you.